So my name is Dr. Nick Engerer. I'm the CTO and co-founder of a solar technology company called Solcast. And in my spare time, I like to do research on biohacking and longevity technologies. And one of the key reasons I'm interested in longevity is that we're currently in a period of time where the technologies available for taking care of ourselves proactively, like coming here to the Health Nucleus, as well as technologies that are going to be able to help minimize the damages that happen to our body from the age-related processes are really becoming available to a wider audience. And so I find a lot of passion and interest and drive in sharing information about those technologies with anyone who cares to listen and is interested in looking after their own health. So I've had experiences in the typical health clinic, you know, many times over my life. And each of those times it's really been to treat an acute problem that I knew I had something going on with, and I'd go in and consult the doctor with specific complaints. So when I look at my motivations for coming to the Health Nucleus, they're a bit more ahead of the curve. I want to know if I'm going to experience things in the future, if I'm likely to have a certain ailment and approach it preventatively. So those two things are contrasted pretty clearly. Another thing that I've noticed about the experience in a typical clinic versus the Health Nucleus is that in a typical clinic, I would tend to be, you know, ushered through in an efficient manner, kind of looking for the problem, finding the prescripted solution, in and out, done and dusted. But in the Health Nucleus, I'm here for a few hours. I'm interacting with many different health professionals and undergoing a wide array of testing. And that last point is another point of contrast. It's the rather than taking a prescriptive approach to blood tests and looking for specific things that are related to an acute condition or a specific problem that you think you have or the doctor suspects you may have, instead we're looking at a broad spectrum of tests to try to be, again, proactive about what we can find in that information. Going through an MRI machine is definitely a unique experience. I often describe it as a mixture of strange vibrations and Atari gaming sounds. So you get in there, it's a bit of a small space, and so some people can feel a bit nervous about that, but you get to pick some relaxing music, you have good cues from supportive staff in your ears, and you also can choose to have a sedative if you need it. I personally chose to use meditation and focusing on my breathing, and overall found it to be pretty relaxing once I forgot that I was in a tight, small tube.
My favorite part about the whole visit, I'm heading into the MRI machine. I'm gonna spend a little over an hour in there, two different sessions. I'm gonna look at all of my internal organs, basically from head to pelvis, and in particular, zooming in on my brain and in on my heart. And I get to choose some sweet tunes to listen to relax on, and also pick some relaxing colors. Last time I did a purple, today I did like more of a relaxing orange-yellow color. And now I'm gonna head in there and get scanned.
But what's really cool about the MRI machine is that you actually can feel it's scanning your body. You get certain responses to the machine, none of it not, you know, uncomfortable, but you can definitely feel parts of your body twitching or vibrating and hearing all these cool sounds. And I like to think about being surrounded by awesome technology, looking at the inside of my body. And, you know, I find it to be a pretty cool experience. In my follow-up visit, I'm really curious to gather more data. So as a scientist, I like to have data points to reflect where my body's at. In particular, given my last visit around 18 to 20 months ago, I've made a lot of lifestyle changes. I've gotten into a really good cardio exercise routine, I'm adding in a bit more weightlifting, and I've changed my diet a lot, all at the behest of my Health Nucleus doctor. And so that is a great thing to measure after you've made those changes, and I get to look at not only how my body composition has changed with the MRI data, but also see the blood panel information to see things like how my metabolic markers have changed, how my lipid markers have changed, and some of those important vitamins like vitamin D or vitamin B12. And so taking that data away, I can see, do I need to tweak things any further to keep optimizing, or am I generally on the right path? So during my first visit, of course, I didn't know quite what to expect. So I felt a bit nervous, you know, a bit of nervous and excitement, we'll call it, put together. And so coming back to the Health Nucleus, it felt like coming back to something that was a bit more familiar. I knew what to expect. I knew I was going to get this beautiful private suite to myself and have this cool team of people coming in and out throughout the day, checking in on me, making sure, you know, I didn't go hungry and had good coffee. So it was overall a really welcoming experience to come back, and, you know, wonderful follow-up to the first one. Looking forward to the next one.